It's Dog Cherry, a.k.a. Snoop LaFleur, or as they like to call me, 99 plus 2, the greater one. And today, I'm talking about hockey tradition. Hockey is a game with a lot of tradition, because it's old as hell. And if you don't know what's going on, some of the traditions can be confusing. But don't worry, I'm gonna break it down. Preds fans have been throwing catfish on the ice for good luck since 2003. Throwing a catfish on the ice seems weird, but don't tell these guys that. I heard that guys stuff it in their pants and they wait until the right moment and they toss that catfish on the ice and someone has to come scoop it up, scoop up fish guts. But catfish got like a little mustache on him, you understand what I'm saying? The Nashville fans probably got their idea from these crazy Detroit fans who've been throwing octopus on the ice for decades. Look at that 6, 7, 8-legged monster they picked up. Nasty. I don't even know how you get an octopus from the venue, but who walks around? Oh, look at him, he's so nasty. It's not just seafood, though. In Florida, half the fans used to throw rats on the ice, but they got stopped pretty quick because, come on, man, rats? Hats on the ice is fine, though. After a player scores 3 goals in the same game, people toss their hats on the ice. Some teams keep the hats, some give them to charity, and some just put them into the lost and found. I'd burn them. I don't want some dude's old hat with dandruff and all kind of stuff in his head. Don't they get you lice? There's another tradition that I like is when the goalie gets smacked, right? Watch how they smack him, bang. That's love right there, going to cool off a little bit, like a slush. What I love is how the players at the end of the game raise their sticks to thank the fans for their love and support. It's like a congratulations thing, man. Congratulations. And thank you for being with us through the win or the loss. It's a great tradition, man. And in Chicago, when that Star Spangled Banner come on, they just cheer. You don't even hear the singer that singing. So if Carl Lewis or Fergie was to sing the national anthem, you wouldn't even hear them. You'd hear nothing but cheers. Oh. And probably one of the most underrated things in hockey is the way they shake hands at the end and they say, we're gonna leave it on the ice. So no matter if we had a fight, or if we had a great series, or a tough, you know, battle, we're gonna shake hands and let's go get something to drink, man, talk about it. You dig? And the most patented tradition is hoisting that cup. That thing right there, is that the Stanley? Stanley special, man. When you hold Stanley, man, you get to pour a drink in Stanley, you get to take Stanley all over the world and have him for a day and hug him and kiss him and mwah. That is a great tradition to hoist that thing. That means that you are the NHL champ. I'll be back again with more from Hockey 101. My lessons are becoming the newest tradition in hockey. Dig that. Ain't nothing like playoff hockey, baby.